In a previous video, I tested the strength of finger joint lumber, which uses finger joints for end-to-end joinery, and it was weaker than I thought it should be. So I thought I'd make my own using a finger joint rotor bit, but that was unusable. So I thought I'd try that V-joint that I tried in the previous video again, but this time with the table saw just tilted 15 degrees instead of 20 degrees, which will make for a longer joint, so hopefully that'll be a fair bit stronger than what I had last time. And setting this up is actually fairly easy, because once you've cut that point, you just line the top of the blade up with the point, and that'll line it up for the V part. And I made a bunch of samples and tried three different glues, including Gorilla wood glue, which I hadn't used in a while, and of course, the top of the glue bottle was all dried up and plugged up, so that took a while to clear it up again. So I've got a bunch of pieces glued end to end, and these really feel like they're one piece, but let's break them to see how strong. The supports on here are 27 centimeters apart. This is 22 by 22 millimeters, and I've got this little bracket here to apply the force not directly on the joint, so it's a bit more like a four-point bending test. 117 kilograms. The tight bond three joints were stronger, but only by about 20%. And for reference, I also broke some pieces without joints in them, which deflected quite a lot before they broke. I tested regular yellow glue and tight bond 3 as well as solid pieces with no joint, and the yellow glue was about 61% of the break strength of the solid piece, whereas tight bond 3 was 73%. So not as strong as a solid piece without a joint, but considerably better than any of the finger joints I tested in softwood in my previous video. My hardwood test pieces are a bit smaller at 20 by 20 millimeters because I wasn't sure if my machine was going to be strong enough. If all else were equal, these should be about 75% of the strength of the larger geometry. Well, that was a 100% glue failure. Same force, also all glue failure. This next joint has got a bit of a gap here and here, so I don't expect this one to do super well. And then testing some hardwood pieces without joints. These had an impressive amount of deflection before they actually broke. But with so much deflection on those hardwood pieces, I stressed one until the force curve started to flatten out a bit, and then released the force. So this piece now has a slight bit of permanent deformation. I thought it'd be more. Now with my hardwood maple samples, the wood was much stronger, and if I adjust for the fact that the geometry was a bit smaller, the breaking strength was about twice that it was for the softwood. And so the glue is much more of a limiting factor. The yellow glue was just half the breaking strength. Gorilla wood glue a little bit more at 53%, and the tight bond 3, excluding the gappy sample, was about 59% of full breaking strength. But if I don't want to permanently deform the wood, I have to limit myself to 250 kilograms, at which point Gorilla wood glue and tight bond 3 are about two-thirds of the usable strength of the hardwood. And a lot of people have commented that I should just use finger joints like this, but these have a natural break where half the wood essentially has a discontinuity, so I figured these should only be half the strength of the wood at best. Let's start with my two softwood samples. And adding those two samples to my spreadsheet here, they're weaker than the yellow glue V-joint and the tight bond V-joint, and only about 44% the strength of a solid, so not impressive. Okay, let's break the maple samples. Glue failure. And that was tight bond 3, which tends to do quite well. But having a closer look, there's actually quite a lot of fiber that transferred from one side to the other. So it's not so much that the glue let go, it's that the wood liked letting go right at the joint line. And with the maple, my finger joints glued with tight bond 3 did quite a bit worse than the V joints with tight bond 3, and still worse than the other glues for the V joints, and quite a bit worse than solid, maybe 43% of solid. So in terms of strength, my finger joints were weaker than V joints. Of course, I could have made the fingers a bit longer, but if the grain isn't completely straight, that can actually become counterproductive. So with a 15 degree blade tilt, these were not too difficult to cut, and I can cut a reasonable thickness of stock that way. But given that I was only at half the strength with some of the glues, I should really make this twice as long, which would make it a joint like this, which is getting to be ridiculous because the depth of cut I would need just for a modest thickness of wood is quite high. If I went to 10 degrees, that might be workable for thinner stuff. And I also thought about if I put two of these side by side, sort of like this, then I could make it shallower or go wider, but getting that lined up with two V's is just way too difficult. So this joint is about as good as I can do with the V's, I think.